In the isolated corners of the world, some animals have shrunk or grown in ways that science cannot fully explain. Isolated islands are not just hidden paradises from the human eye, but also nature's laboratories. Here, life transcends boundaries, rewriting the rules in ways that challenge the limits of science. In this journey, you will witness how some of the world's islands have transformed their animals into characters akin to those from a fantasy novel, in unexpected ways. From the hobbits of Flores Island to Madagascar's mini hippopotamuses, these fascinating creatures showcase just how surprising and unpredictable evolution can be. Islands often act as natural laboratories on their own. Remote and isolated, these places often cause animals and plants to undergo an evolutionary process that is quite different from their homeland. This phenomenon is known in the scientific community as island dwarfism or insular dwarfism. But what does this mean? Insular dwarfism describes the process by which some large animal species living on islands evolve over time to smaller sizes. This phenomenon is usually seen on islands where food resources are limited and there are few or no predators. Smaller sizes allow animals to survive on less food, thus helping them survive with limited resources. Conversely, some animals grow through a process called island gigantism, the exact opposite phenomenon. Isolation can cause some small animals to reach larger sizes because, in the absence of natural enemies, being larger provides them ecological advantages. One of the most famous examples of these impressive evolutionary adaptations is Homo floresiensis, discovered on Indonesia's Flores Island and nicknamed Hobbit. This small human species is a living proof that island dwarfism can occur not only among animals, but also among humans. These small-sized species are critically important in understanding how they survive in the limited ecosystems of islands and how they adapt to their environments. They also showcase the complexity and dynamism of evolution and natural selection. Flores Island, Indonesia, is famous for the discovery of Homo floresiensis, also known as the Hobbit. This small human species, dating back about 50,000 years, had an adult height of only about 1 meter. These small sizes may have helped them adapt to Flores's limited resources. The islands of Sicily and Malta are known for their prehistoric dwarf elephants. These dwarf elephants, dating from the Pleistocene period and extinct about 10,000 years ago, were actually miniature versions of their massive mainland relatives. Thanks to insular dwarfism, their size was about a third of that of normal elephants. In Sicily, there are ancient stories and mythological elements related to the dwarf elephants. These elephants have sometimes been mentioned as mystical creatures in the island's mythology and have occasionally appeared in Sicily's rich folkloric narratives. These are stories that often symbolize the island's natural history and the effects of geological isolation. Komodo dragons are large reptiles living on Indonesia's Komodo Island and can be seen as an example of island gigantism. These creatures can grow up to 3 meters in length and weigh up to 70 kilograms. The large size of the Komodo dragons has developed as an adaptation to the scarcity of natural predators on the islands and the presence of large mammals to hunt. These giant lizards have adapted to the challenges of island life with their large size, making them impressive predators. They are known for their venomous bites, which give them the capacity to incapacitate large prey. Komodo dragons have become an important cultural symbol for the people of Komodo Island. According to local legends, these large reptiles are seen as protective spirits and are considered part of the island's natural balance. Such beliefs have helped in the conservation of Komodo dragons and in fostering respect for these creatures among the local people. Madagascar has been home to many unique species like dwarf hippopotamuses. These hippos were much smaller than their normal-sized relatives, some only about 1 meter tall and weighing a few hundred kilograms. Madagascar's limited water resources and forested habitats may have contributed to the evolution of these small sizes. The extinction of the dwarf hippos occurred with human settlement on the island and the destruction of their habitats. The Channel Islands off the west coast of North America were home to dwarf mammoths that went extinct about 13,000 years ago. These mammoths were a fraction of the size of their mainland counterparts. The existence of dwarf mammoths is considered an example of the evolution of small sizes due to limited food and living space on the islands. In the Caribbean islands, dwarf planet jumpers are an example of island dwarfism. Unlike normal-sized terrestrial rodents, these species have evolved to be much smaller. This adaptation occurred due to the scarcity of predators and the need to cope with limited resources. New Zealand once hosted various species of moa, including dwarf moas, which were much smaller versions of the larger moas, their size only a fraction of their larger relatives. This dwarf size is associated with effective hiding and food-finding abilities in the island's forested areas. The Balearic Islands in the Mediterranean have hosted dwarf horse species in prehistoric times. These horses were miniature versions of their mainland counterparts, and their size was not even half that of a standard horse. These small sizes may have helped them adapt to the island's limited resources, as they could survive on less food and occupy less space. The island of Crete in ancient times hosted a type of dwarf giraffe known as Palaeotragus microceros. These giraffes had only a fraction of the size of modern giraffes. Crete's limited space and resources made sustainability of large bodies challenging, while smaller-sized animals could survive on less nutrition. These species represent a striking example of the island dwarfism phenomenon and show how they adapted to the ecological limitations of the island. The Sunda Islands in prehistoric times hosted dwarf rhinoceros species. These rhinos reached only a part of the size of their mainland relatives, and these small sizes arose from the need to adapt to the island's limited resources. Dwarf rhinos typically evolved to survive more efficiently in smaller habitat areas, which allowed them to consume less energy and resources. The phenomena of island dwarfism and island gigantism offer both advantages and disadvantages to organisms living on isolated islands. These adaptations are extraordinary examples of how species respond to the ecological and environmental conditions of their habitats. Small sizes allow more efficient use of limited food resources on islands. These creatures can survive in resource scarcity by consuming less energy and managing with less food. Small sizes also attract less attention on islands with few predators. This can increase the survival chances of species, especially in environments with low predator pressure. Dwarf or giant sizes allow for better adaptation to specific ecological niches. For example, a small-sized animal can move more effectively in tight spaces, while a large animal can feed on larger prey. Isolation often leads to smaller population sizes, and therefore a reduction in genetic diversity. This can make species more susceptible to environmental changes and diseases. If island conditions change, specialized adaptations such as small or large sizes may limit species' ability to adapt to new conditions. This can increase the risk of extinction. Small populations may also face difficulties in population growth due to reproductive failures and low genetic diversity. This can jeopardize the long-term sustainability of species. These advantages and disadvantages determine how quickly and effectively island-dwelling species can respond to changes in their ecosystems. Evolution is a continuous process, and organisms living in these isolated habitats must continue to adapt to changes in their environments. The phenomena of island dwarfism and island gigantism, while drawing great interest in the scientific community, also provide important lessons for conservation efforts. Studying these unique evolutionary adaptations teaches us a lot about biodiversity and ecosystem health. Island dwarfism helps us understand the effects of isolation and environmental pressures on the physical characteristics of species within the field of evolutionary biology. These phenomena aid in a better understanding of adaptation and natural selection mechanisms. Examining how these species have responded to past and current environmental changes allows us to develop more effective strategies against global issues like climate change. Many examples of island dwarfism involve species that are endangered or already extinct. Conserving these species contributes to the preservation of biodiversity and the health of ecosystems. Protecting island habitats ensures the survival of these unique species, as well as other life forms in island ecosystems. Habitat restoration projects can help revive the natural flora and fauna populations of islands. As we can see, island dwarfism is not just a subject of biological curiosity, but also of great importance in terms of environmental conservation and sustainability. Protecting these species is vital for maintaining the biodiversity of islands and, consequently, our world. Island dwarfism offers a valuable window into the understanding of evolution and the natural world, urging us to be more conscious and responsive in protecting our planet. If you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel. See you in the next video.